I wish I had an explanation for the popularity of the man I'm about to introduce, but a gift such as his apparently cannot really be explained, but it can be felt and enjoyed. So why don't we just do that? Let's do it for him, gang.
Yeah. Yeah. Yo, girl got a cute face. Her friend got a nice body. They just wanna have fun. This is my type of party. 20 bitches in the lobby. There's plenty bitches in the lobby. They all drinking, they smoking. This is my type of party. My car just
like my parents always been like real into music and shit like that. So like they always used to have records around the house. I always used to like go through them and shit like that. Listen to it. I was around like a lot of like older music growing up. For the DJ thing, I think I saw that Juice movie and that shit like. Like, you know, I remember the DJ, but like that shit, like, that was over for me right there. And it was from that, like, watching that and shit to, like, kind of just keeping it moving and learning more and more and more. So that's how I kind of came into it.
You don't want no problems. You don't want no problems.
It really gave me, like, a lot of background on, like, my music and shit. Because, like, I play, like, everything. And, like, I'm kind of able to, like, zoom in on where people's from just because of the places I've traveled, you know. So, like, I was on the West Coast for a good portion of my life. I was on the East Coast for a good portion of my life. So I know some of these key records that you would only know if you grew up on the West Coast or the East Coast. So, like, I mean, it's definitely helpful, like, with my career is now. So, I mean, some of the disadvantages is, like, not growing up in the same places, friends, shit like that, you always, you know. But, you know, as you get older and shit like that, you learn to adapt more, and then you kind of learn to use it to your advantage, so. I mean, it's crazy because I got out in 2005 and like I graduated high school in Maryland, so whenever you get out the military, they ship you back to wherever you're from or wherever you joined at, so to speak. So I graduated in Maryland, so I joined, whatever. And then when I got out, they shipped me back to Maryland. That's where my parents was still. So we packed up all my shit and then we packed it in the U-Haul and then we drove, me, my mom, my pops, drove like 18 hours, like straight through all the way to South Florida. Did that, like I just got out of shit. And the first place we moved was in Fort Lauderdale. It was off Sunrise Boulevard. And like the first thing I remember seeing, like this was the only place that I've ever been that like, it's like nice. And then like hood as fuck, like right there. Like you just bam, bam, it's right there. So like, I got it's like culture shock a little bit, like coming here. But it's all for the best. Like, it,
y con el lingo tal vez te confundo.
A lot of people who know me, my shit is like, people are like, I don't really have, like, I take a lot of, like, you know, bits and pieces from shit I like, but I don't try to, I never mimic anything, and I never try to fucking, like, I never try to see an act and be like, oh, I need this. Like, maybe I see somebody's shit and I'm like, oh, I like that, that's dope. I take a lot of shit and I try to put my own little flavor, my own little twist. People see crazy shit, I wear colors, like, it's my personality. I mean, people see me and be like, yo, I couldn't wear that, but you can get away with some shit like that. My white nigga is like a neon fucking quad angle, like it's bright as fuck, but hey, you ride that nigga. But it's just my personality. I'll try to be over the top and shit, you know, if I like it. The movies on the plane, like I had some fucking like Journey socks. They was like purple and fucking blue, or no, purple and gray and black. And so, and I was wearing like Adidas chancletas. I got a plane. Why are you wearing socks? Like, it's just me. Like, you know, I try to be comfortable. I'm comfortable. You shouldn't worry about it. That's just my fashion sense. I don't really try to box myself in. It's just that push, man. Like, everybody that you see associated with it. You see, like, I stay on the beach. You see 89 down here. You see the stickers. Like, it's everything about the culture, fashion, the merchandising, the branding, who they're fucking with in the game. You know what I'm saying? Everything is my steeds. Like, Peso, Naps, Ray, they all show me love from our front, and that's how it should be. And that's what it is. Like, we show me love, we show each other love, we build, we grow, and that's what it is. Like, that's why, you know, they approached me, and I was like, it's all love. Like, it's...
morning when I wake up.
And like my whole shit is like focusing on the ultimate goal. And after you reach your ultimate goal, in my eyes, everything opens up. Like, you know, my goal right now is obviously the production shit, like get all my shit for the production stuff, but not music. Obviously, like to kind of conquer like the club scene, travel, stuff like that, kind of grow my stuff. But obviously, like my thing right now is I want to start the music shit. I want to start putting out my own thing. I want people to kind of find my OEA mixes and shit like that, see what I'm about. And by that time, I want to have some music going and have like my artist point on. So people start booking me as an artist, kind of flowing with the same type of like mixtapes I've been doing, my OEA shit, putting my music. I want to show them, like, you know. And after that, like after I start peaking, I want to start making different relationships. I want to start building with different people, and I want to kind of grow into another kind of like enterprise.
They come from all around the world for the
welcome to 7:40. He got here like what, 10 something? Whatever. He was in fucking Mexico yesterday. Flew back today to fucking do Arcadia on Saturday. And now he's fucking talking about a pool party on Sunday. This is the definition of never sleep. DJ Aliyo, my nigga right here. I know I was fucking whack as fuck, but
yeah.
Yo, but DJ Aliyo is definitely the definition of no fucking sleep. None.
Yo.
What fucking Arcadia? He's smart. Yo, because he know.
I just want everybody to know. I want everybody to know.
Yeah. Hold on, stop. Shut up. Yo, what you fucking Fiji? Who the fuck? Yo, I never been to a club that gives you Fiji.
Listen.
They don't give me Zephyr Hills. I hope you get all of these. They gave me fucking Fiji, my nigga. Fiji. Fiji is like fucking $5 in the store.